Hello. Sound already desynced. Hopefully it comes back. There we go. Yeah, it's back. Right? I don't even know why it does that. Yeah, it didn't take that long. It was only about a minute or so. Yeah. I'm gonna try a different route for the early game. See if I can gain some speed in the long run. Yeah, I want to try capturing more ships per battle and selling them, and then not having to bother capturing any ships later on because I'll have all the money I need early on. But I need to hire some more sailors to command the ships. I think I can do that by going to a different port right off the bat. That'll also let me buy a faster ship sooner, so less time sailing. Alright, now I've hired two more guys, so I can, capture two more ships per battle. Yeah, and this port has a high chance of spawning what is not necessarily the fastest ship in the game, but it's the best ship for combat in the game right off the start. And it's not the fastest, but it's definitely up there in speed, so I feel like that's a good trade-off. It's gonna be a bit slower at the beginning, because I have to wait for the ships that are going to fight me to sail here all the way from Spain. But in the long run, I think it'll be faster, because I won't have to spend so much time capturing and selling ships later on. Here they come. Transfer my crew first, that's okay. Yeah, exactly. So that'll save a lot of time in the pub and money on recruiting new crew. So Again, won't need to capture so many ships for the cash. Pretty sure I can afford the ship right off the bat now, actually. That's not what I meant to do. Still terrible at menuing, though. Ha. Huh. Buttons. How do those work? Sell that yet? Right? I actually get mad at games sometimes when it doesn't do what I wanted it to do. I'm just like, you know what I meant! Set for the game. Quick time events, just an interactive cutscene anyway. Like, come on, give me a break. Thank you. now grab three more ships, and I should be able to be set for a little while for cash. How the game is just so sure that I was going to lose that fight, that win or lose, it still plays the cutscene as if you lost. Did the playtesters even try to find a workaround? Because it's not that hard, to be honest. I keep forgetting to reassign my crew. One day I'll remember. It's like the spoopy boat up around Spoopsville. Yeah, we don't see it in this run. No reason to go up there. Thank you. Actually, I'm gonna capture these galleons. Because they're worth a lot of money. Just to have a little bit of safety money. Won't have to capture anything else for the rest of the game, I think, after this. Yeah, like, he rolled up to my ship there, and he... It's like he knew I was gonna attack him on my turn anyway, so he's just like... YOLO. This captured ship slowing me down. Alright. But I won't need any... Pretty sure I won't need to worry about money for the rest of the game after this. So I can just... not worry about the whole capturing ships... process. A boat! Purpose in capturing ships now would be if I wanted to get the best arms and armor in the game, but no real point to it. Although I could probably defeat fleets faster. Or maybe not, actually. Probably take about the same amount of time. Plus, it would take the time to gather the money. Not worth it. Fight you. don't have to replace my crew after every battle either, so I can do more battles without without restocking. Still have to repair the ship once in a while, though. I'm already a third of the way to the amount of piracy XP I need. Yeah, if I can just go from story trigger to story trigger. Love that line, although I might have gone through it too quick to notice when he it's like, as a token of my thanks, let me play a song on my lute for you. Toss a coin to your pirate. wasted a few seconds, but that's okay. Now I know. A lot of the story triggers in this one also involve fighting, which then also increases your fame or your piracy XP. So then you use that to progress to the next story trigger. It's kind of ideal. Shut up, dog face. There are some pretty good insults or one-liners, like, we're just regular pirates, not arsonists at all. So even though I'm on my way to a story trigger, I'm still gonna stop and fight this guy so that I don't have to scrounge for XPs later. Same with these guys. I'm just gonna fight easy opponents as I come across them, so that the battles go quickly, instead of finding I need experience at the end and only being able to find difficult opponents. And I can take both of these guys. Then might not even have to do any hunting later on. Just get all the XP I need from the story. Not if you do what I'm doing now and just hitting targets of opportunity that are going to be nice and quick. Otherwise, there can be a little bit. Oh, and sound desynced again. Comes back quickly again. Guy snuck by me at night. Now I gotta go chase him. And it's back. Lisbon. Since I'm in the relative area, I'm gonna go up to Bordeaux and get some bombs for when we have to sail around Africa. Thank you. Is the item shop open? 8, maybe? Bombs. Shall we repair the ship one here? Top of the crew. Couple fights coming up. So we need 8,000 more XP for to hit all the story points, so I'm sure I'll get those as I do the scripted fights. My defense and being tricked into it. Rescuing there is part of Joao's story. I guess technically part of Catalina's too, because you encounter Joao and he's in the midst of rescuing her. I do like that there's a bit of difference in the cutscene there. If you arrive early, you're waiting on her, and if you arrive late, she's waiting on you. You should. They're pretty fun. If I may make a suggestion, I would start with Ernst, because his run is pretty chill. You're just making a map of the world, and then there's a subplot where it's a cute waifu, and she's an orphan, so they're sailing the world trying to find out where she's from. Yeah, if you just get a Zumi ship right off the bat, or not necessarily right off the bat, but fairly early in, then you can avoid combat entirely, because there's no reason for you to start a fight, and if some pirates try to pick on you, if you got a Zumi ship, you can just outrun them. Since you have to sail the whole world, you can go to all the different ports and check out all of the unique ships. Spend the time investing in Japan to get the super obscure ships that are there. And even the characters with a lot of combat, you don't have to micromanage the crew so much like I do in this run, because normally you won't be using just a single ship, you'll have a whole fleet of ships. Yeah, you can either like optimize it and just have like a whole fleet of the best ships you can find, or you can use it as an excuse to collect a whole bunch of different types of ships that you just happen to like. Okay. Let's save here, because I'm gonna have to be quick about this. Oh, maybe this will be close enough. Yes. Ah, but it's night. You gotta be careful with this one, if you're doing what I'm doing and micromanaging the crew, because if you're ever on the same square as him, it automatically triggers the fight. There we go. If you were running this on stream, I'd have to bite my tongue, or my fingers, I suppose, so I wouldn't be backseat gaming. Cousin named Brett in New Zealand. I've only met him once. It was, I wasn't very old when I met him. Yes, he does. It's actually my mother's cousin, so I guess that makes him my second cousin. Now my next story trigger should trigger after next time I get into a combat. I have plenty of XP, so I won't be waiting on that. We'll fix towards the ship since they're just gonna fight. Best target here. There you go. Thank you. model the ship, so we can go around Africa in one trip, don't have to stop for supplies. Not the zoomiest ship, but it's still pretty zoomy. I think it makes up for it because you can finish battles a lot quicker with it than with some other ships. Yeah, a lot of time in this particular run is spent fighting, so... You only really have two long trips. You have this one around Africa, and the trip back, of course, and then, across the Atlantic to South America. And hopefully we won't spend too much time bumming around South America trying to find the story trigger, since it is in a random port. The only time I've gotten on the first try was my first timed run. when I didn't really have any idea what I was doing at all. So it's still, even though I got it on the first try, it was still a 5-hour and 48-minute run. Every time I've done a full run, I've managed to save time, so hopefully I'll continue that tradition this run. I absolutely did not mean to do that. Oh. Scheiße. Yes, surprisingly. It'll be a huge time loss, but if I can survive 10 rounds, it ends in a draw. Yeah, my cat will do that too. If he thinks his favorite toys are, sometimes he'll knock them under the fireplace, because we don't have a real fireplace. We have like a infrared one that doubles as our TV stand, and he'll knock them under there, and I'll move them, but he thinks they're still under there, so he loses his mind. I suppose, look at it that way. Although my last run, I got into a fight like this as well, because I let my crew get too low, so the enemy commander was able to challenge me. I'm surprised I was able to hold out with no equipment. Although Catalina does start off with her battle level at like 6 or something, or 9, where most characters start at 1, so. I like how Petra just comes out of the woodwork with, "Well, actually, I have exposition that proves you wrong." How she refers to herself as a female pirate in that dialogue. Like, I don't think she really needs to emphasize the fact that she's female. Again, so we can sail back to Europe. Like, I get that it's an abnormality for the time period, so other characters might refer to her as a female pirate to distinguish her from other pirates, but why would she refer to herself as a female pirate, not just a pirate? Pretty sure she's aware of her own gender. Speaking of cats and losing their mind where they think things are, when I was in Edmonton, we were living in military housing, and there was a little crack in the drywall in the ceiling. And I don't know if he saw a bug climb in there once or what, but he would just sit on the floor and stare at that crack in the ceiling and meow at it. At least he had a reason for it. Now he just meows at the ceiling where there's nothing. The haunted ceiling crack. have to do a little grinding. 2,000 more XP to get the final story trigger. But you have to fight a ship to trigger it anyway, so maybe I'll get enough XP from the next ship that I won't have to fight an additional one after that. Let's see. You'll do. It's almost dark. Morning. Again with the sound. I don't know why it's happening so often this run, but it's not dropping the frame rate. Yeah, I don't really know why it does it. I need one more battle to trigger the story anyway. So I need my 30,000 XP and then getting one last fight. Can't That'd be that fight that sets me over the... Sure, I'll fight you. Interesting. Why is it not triggering? Yeah, that's a good point. Your first mate will warn you when there's a storm, but you'll take a little bit of damage because you won't get that initial sound warning that you can head it off right away. has got quite a large fleet, making it difficult to get to him. Oh, come on. I just don't want to go into the last fight damaged, otherwise the enemy might sink me. I've taken a lot of damage this fight too, just because being outmaneuvered. Of plenty of crew, though. There we go, finally. Man, that wasted a lot of time. That's a pain. Kind of weird with the sound gun. See, it's not even giving that like clicking sound of it trying to resync. It's just gone. There we go. I wonder if I had to go to the. If I was going to the wrong place. Because I was checking the pub. Maybe I had to check the shipyard the whole time. finish this cutscene, then we can go to South America. Hopefully we'll get the trigger right away. So much ocean. Yeah, see, I would have liked to have some sound to know there's a storm before I got warned about it. Oh man, I got the trigger on the first try. Now I actually want to lose this fight, because it'll be faster to lose it. Perfect. Gotta rebuild my crew. It's fine. Right, now with the amount of crew I have, I have to be careful about which of these pirates I pick a fight with. Heck. That really screws me. I don't think I can win. I don't have the crew now to fight this guy. No, I can do something else though. Thinking fast enough, should have done this right from the start. No, he's faster than me. God damn it. Well, no sub 220. I can still get a PB though. Need sub 227 to get a PB. only hire 8 crew at a time in this port. Jesus. Have to head back to Havana. Maybe this guy's doubling back. If I hadn't messed up earlier and gotten to that that duel when I was fighting the Turkish fleet, yeah, I would have had it. So it's really my own fault, but now I can do it next time. So there's that at least. Minutes off, still not bad. Yeah, birthday PD, PB. Yeah, a new strat, and even with using that new strat, I was even seeing some places along the way that I can optimize, plus not making basic mistakes. Work on my menuing. There's plenty of places I can improve this. My goal is to get sub 2 hours, because for when they open submissions for Limit Break next year, I want to submit this. Since it's so obscure, I don't think they'll take it if it's a long run, so I want it to be sub 2 hours. The Japanese world record is 1:30, I think, but you can skip text, which you can't do, so this one will never be as fast as Japanese, but I think sub 220 is still possible, or sub 2 hours, rather. Anyway, yeah, if I get really good at the menus and I don't need to read anything, then I could run Japanese. I don't know, I think I like the English text better for a marathon, because if you're a quick enough reader, though I'm mashing through the text as fast as possible, you can still read it and still get the story. Of course, I could always use the war percentage as well. Like when Yago was running Tales of Fantasia, he ran Japanese version because it was faster, but he was still giving lower percent as he did it. Alright, well, that's my run for today, so thank you for joining me. I'm gonna throw a host actually. Doc's running some Earthbound. Let's throw him a post.